According to World Health Organization, in 2022, nearly half of the world's population was at risk of malaria. That year, there were about 249 million cases of malaria worldwide, and the estimated number of malaria deaths stood at 608,000. Sub-Saharan Africa carries a disproportionately high share of the global malaria burden. In 2022, the region was home to 94% of malaria cases and 96% of malaria deaths. Children under 5 years of age accounted for about 76% of all malaria deaths. Malaria is a life-threatening disease caused by plasmodium parasites that are transmitted through the bites of the infected female Anopheles mosquitoes. With the correct interventions, malaria is preventable and curable. The WHO recommends protection for all people at risk of malaria with effective malarial vector control, including insecticide-treated mosquito nets and indoor residual spraying. Malaria is an acute febrile illness. The first symptoms are usually fever, headache, and chills, which may be mild, making it difficult to recognize as malaria. If not treated within 24 hours, P. falciparum malaria can progress to severe malaria, often leading to death. Children with severe malaria frequently develop danger signs alongside severe anemia, respiratory distress in relation to metabolic acidosis, or cerebral malaria. In adults, multi-organ failure is also frequent. Resistance to anti-malarial medicines is a recurring problem. Protecting the efficacy of anti-malarial medicines is critical to malaria control and elimination. This includes administering the drugs correctly, at the correct dose, and for the entire duration of treatment.
In this high dependency unit, we receive very sick children and we treat children with severe malaria.
These children present with danger signs, loss of consciousness and coma. They will often be hypoglycemic and convulsing. They will be dehydrated and anemic, and some will have multi-system failure, including renal impairment and metabolic acidosis and shock. Others have received a pre-referral intervention prior to reaching us, such as rectal artesunate, or they may have been administered the first dose of injectable artesunate as a parenteral injection. They may not present with severe danger signs because the first dose given as a pre-referral intervention has begun the work, but they will deteriorate if we don't follow guidelines and manage the child with injectable artesunate, then complete the treatment with a full 3-day course of ACT before sending them home.
Once the child arrives at the hospital, we know that early diagnosis and prompt treatment will save their life. We quickly initiate urgent treatment steps while getting a thorough history from the caregiver and making sure to review referral notes. We take vital signs, resuscitate the patient, establish intravenous access, and quickly correct for any hypoglycemia. Meanwhile, we take samples for analysis. Once we have stabilized the patient, we can then administer injectable artesunate.
Injectable artesunate is the first-line treatment recommended by WHO for severe malaria in both children and adults, including pregnant women, during all trimesters. It is a short-acting agent that kills parasites very rapidly at all stages of the parasite cycle, resulting in more rapid recovery. Clinical evidence from 2 large-scale, multi-center trials in Southeast Asia and Africa showed a reduction in the risk of death using injectable artesunate compared to quinine. If used throughout Africa, injectable artesunate could save up to an additional 195,000 lives each year. The priority with severe malaria is to initiate treatment with as little delay as possible. A new formulation of injectable artesunate has become available. This demonstration film illustrates how to use the 60 milligrams quick and easy to prepare formula. The intention is that this formula is easier and faster to prepare and involves fewer steps and therefore potentially less risk of errors in preparation. The new injectable formulation does not need dilution. It is also used at the same concentration of 20 milligrams per milliliter for intravenous and intramuscular administration. The new formulation only requires one step to reconstitute with the arginine sodium bicarbonate solvent. The solvent is added to the drug to adjust and stabilize pH and optimize drug solubility and stability. We will now show you how to prepare and administer the new formulation of 60 milligrams injectable artesunate for severe malaria. Refer to drug insert to apply the principles presented here to the other three doses. Injectable artesunate can be safely used in all infants and children of any weight. Refer to your national guidelines for any local regulations. Please ensure that you are using a quality assured drug. This formula of injectable artesunate is prescribed at a dose of 3.0 milligrams per kilogram for children weighing less than 20 kilograms and at a dose of 2.4 milligrams per kilogram for children and adults over 20 kilograms. It can be administered via IV, intravenous, or via IM, intramuscular injection. It should never be administered as an intravenous drip. The drug is packaged as follows: one vial containing a crystalline powder of artesunate, one large ampoule of 6 milliliters of sodium bicarbonate plus arginine solvent to activate the drug.
The most important part in artesunate preparation is to carefully follow the steps. The reconstitution entails only one part, so it's very easy to prepare.
The preparation and administration of the new formulation of injectable artesunate can be broken down into five simple steps. Step 1. Weigh the patient. It is essential to weigh the patient as the dose of the new injectable artesunate formula is weight dependent. Step 2. Calculate the number of milliliters you need. Refer to the dosing schedules. Or calculate as follows. As shown earlier, a child weighing 8.8 kilograms needs 26.4 milligrams. To give this via the intravenous route or intramuscular route, divide 26.4 milligrams by the drug concentration of 20 milligrams per milliliter. Round up to the next whole number, to 2 milliliters. Check your calculation twice. Unlike the previous two-step formula, the drug concentration of IV and IM for this formula is the same, 20 milligrams per milliliter. Step 3 involves checking the number of vials needed. The number of vials is based on the patient weight. For example, the number of vials needed for this adult is equal to the weight of the patient in kilograms, multiplied by 2.4 milligrams per kilogram of body weight, divided by the dose of the vial, in this case, 60 milligrams. So, our patient weighing 8.8 kilograms will require that we reconstitute one vial. For an adult patient weighing 72.5 kg who needs a dose of 2.4 milligrams per kilogram, you will need 3 vials. Step 4 involves reconstituting the artesunate powder with the sodium bicarbonate and arginine solvent. By adding the sodium bicarbonate and arginine solvent to the artesunate powder, you are activating the drug. First, remove the seal at the top of the artesunate vial. Open the sodium bicarbonate and arginine solvent ampoule with a swab. Using a syringe to draw the full contents of the sodium bicarbonate and arginine ampoule and inject it directly into the artesunate vial with the powder. Shake gently until the solution is clear. If the solution appears cloudy or precipitate is present, it should be discarded, replaced with a new vial, and start again. The concentration for intravenous administration of the reconstituted drug is 20 milligrams per milliliter, since the sodium bicarbonate, an arginine ampule, has a volume of 3 milliliters. Injectable artesunate is now ready for use. It must be used within 1 hour of preparation. We have weighed the patient, calculated the dose and milliliters to administer. We have activated the drug by reconstituting it. And now we are ready for the last step, administration of the drug. To prepare and administer artesunate injection, you will need some supplies. A clean tray or kidney dish, swabs or cotton with a disinfectant, syringes, correct number of vials, gloves. You must maintain aseptic technique throughout preparation. First, prepare a saline solution to flush the line. Use a swab with a disinfectant solution to clean the IV port. Check the patency of the line. Withdraw the required volume of artesunate solution from the vial with a syringe and then administer to the patient by slow intravenous or intramuscular injection over 1 to 2 minutes. For example, for this pediatric patient, you will administer the 2 milliliters dose over a 50 to 60 seconds period. For the IM dose, you will administer as a slow intramuscular injection over 1 to 2 minutes, spread over various sites as normal. Finally, plan the dosing schedule. Give the first dose on admission and record this as time zero. Give the next dose exactly 12 hours after the initial dose and the third dose at 24 hours after the first dose. Prepare a new solution for each administration and discard any unused solution after each administration. After 3 parenteral doses in the first 24 hours, this patient should receive only 1 dose of artesunate per 24 hours for a maximum of 7 days or until oral medication can be given. As soon as the patient can take oral medication, give the patient a full 3-day course of oral artemisinin combination therapy as recommended in your national treatment guidelines. Evaluate the patient's progress regularly throughout, in particular level of consciousness and anemia and capacity to tolerate oral fluids. Always remember to follow the 5 steps when preparing and administering this new formulation of injectable artesunate. Injectable artesunate prepared and administered correctly saves lives. This new formulation simplifies the preparation steps and saves time.
Injectable artesunate is our number one way of managing patients with severe malaria, and it has really changed the way we manage malaria, because the new formulation is very easy to prepare and to administer. Previously, we used to have so many deaths of children with severe malaria, but with the administration of artesunate, they improve very fast, and a patient whom you felt maybe would die, we see them going home smiling with their parents, and it makes us happy and motivated to continue doing this very challenging work.
I do treat pregnant women with severe malaria. Is this formulation safe in pregnancy?
Severe malaria in pregnancy is very dangerous. Full dose artesunate is well tolerated and can be administered at any trimester, including the first trimester.
In this ward, we treat many children. Is the new formulation of artesunate safe for children under 6 kilograms?
Injectable artesunate can be administered to children irrespective of any weight. The most important factor is to administer the correct dose based on their weight.
How common are the side effects with this new formulation?
Injectable artesunate is remarkably well tolerated. The side effects are rare.
How would we manage an overdose?
In case of suspected overdose, symptomatic and general supportive therapy should be given as appropriate.
Are there any adverse reactions that we should be aware of?
The main adverse reaction that has been noted is delayed hemolytic anemia. This reaction is common in patients with hyperparathyroidism and young children.
time is very critical in the management of severe malaria. So formulations that are easy to prepare, they make our work very easy. So we wish our fellow nurses and clinicians all the best in their work. As we say in Kenya, kazi njema.